Hi, in this lecture, I'm going to show you how to remove this header information because you want the SKF data should be shown striped below to the above information. So how to remove this header information? Because this header information is repeated from the original session 1 and session 2 when you're creating. It's automatically coming even though you didn't do any setup for this text. And how to hide this for only session 2. Session 1, yes, you need this information, which is a header information is needed on the top, but in the session 2 you don't need this information. So here you can also restrict if you don't want the header data. This header data also can be removed. So how to do this? Now I'm going to show you. Let us go to the report in the change mode. So after you go to our report under GRR2, and when you double click, it will be in the change mode. Now let us go to the formatting. Under formatting, you can go to the session overview. So after go here, you can see the sessions, two sessions. One is our session is actual and planned data, and another one is SKF data. So here you can see the page break is showing as a form feed. So it is having it's a default leaf from the form. So the system is taking. Now I just want to give only one blank row for this and another blank row here. And if you don't want the header information, you just say uncheck this one. Then you can check overscore, underscore, and yeah. So for this data, because you are already having the header in the first session, actual plan and variance, so you don't need for the session 2. So now click OK, save. And I recommend whenever you done the changes, go to the GR55 and click on generate. So system will adjust whatever the changes you are doing, and system internally do the programming changes. Now click on execute, enter the physical address and click on exit. Now you can see here the employee information is showing without any header under directly below. So now this is how you can do the reports more flexible with the, in the same report, actual cost, planned cost, and also the statistical key figures which is showing here. So now let us say you want to divide salaries of this employee by the headcount, and you want to derive the what is the SKF data per each headcount. So I will show you in the next session. Thank you.